Hello again, Gary Stearman with another Prophecy in the News Daily Updates Wednesday, October 20th, heading into the fall and heading into, I think, very, very telling prophetic times. Today, we're going to continue our discussion with J.R. Church, and we're going to talk about his new book, and it's called Daniel Reveals the Bloodline of the Antichrist. This book has more in it than you think, so keep watching. JR, We were talking about Daniel 9:24 and following in yesterday's update.
330 pages in this book, and it is a commentary on the 12 chapters of Daniel. In addition to that, I have the 243 missing years in the Jewish calendar, and I have a chapter on the saga of Jupiter and Saturn, and then I have this chart of 6,000 years of history, all the way from the beginning of creation to the year 2240, when the Jews claim that their calendar will come to the year 6,000, and we prove it to be a bogus year.
And I should point out, folks, that J.R. did the calendar the hard way. It took him years. He used astronomical computations that he can do on his computer. He did historical documentation where he looked up historical facts, and he came up with this calendar which explains the missing years in the Jewish calendar, right?
Yeah, and everything else too. Everything fits in place perfectly. And I challenge anyone to prove me wrong on any date or any event. I doesn't mean I'm stubborn. It just, I think everything fits. And if anyone can prove me wrong, they're going to have to, you know, really buckle down to do it. Because this takes, for example, Bishop Usher. He was a month off on the creation date. That's because he was using the Julian calendar. And a few years after he died, Pope Gregory came along and took those 30 days away, you know, or 15 days or so. Anyway, the Gregorian calendar takes us back to September of the year 4004. Anyway, concerning Daniel chapter 9.
Right, and yesterday we had, excuse me just a second, because I'll kind of fill everybody in. We had talked about the 70-week revelation of Daniel. And those 70 weeks are divided in a strange way. They are divided into 7 weeks and 62 weeks, totaling 79.
Totaling 69.
69.
And then the 70th week.
And the 70th week. Now, what a strange way to break things up. And we had just started talking about this yesterday.
Yes. For some reason, there was going to be a gap between the 7th and 8th week. Well, 49 years after the first sabbatical year occurred, we have the death of Ahasuerus. You remember Esther was the queen of Persia.
Right.
And you hear nothing else from her. She is removed as the queen. Her husband is dead. The king is dead. And the king's son, by Vashti, becomes the king of Persia. And so we hear nothing else from Esther. Well, you know, she was the person on behalf of Israel. She was their representative in the palace. And so we launched into troublous times, you remember?
Oh, yes.
After the 7 weeks, there'll be troublous times, and the walls will be built and the foundation laid in troublous times. Well, Ezra and Nehemiah came back during that time, and they had their part. We can read about it in Ezra and Nehemiah. But when we come down to the conclusion of this interregnum, this gap between the 7th and 8th week, we have Malachi, the last book of the Bible, around 400 B.C., and we launch again with the first year following a jubilee and take it all the way to the year 2627 in the Jewish calendar. That would be A.D. 26-27, the sabbatical year. Jesus appears, he's baptized, launches his ministry. 3.5 years later, he's crucified.
And to do that, you have to know where the Jubilee was. And yes. That was part of your research, right?
Yes, that's right. Where to find the Jubilee.
And believe me, folks, that was not easy.
But, you know, in the 1960s, some letters were found in a cave down near the Dead Sea. And they found that Bar Kokhba himself wrote the letters. And Bar Kokhba in one of the letters says that he had rented his property out to a Gentile for 2 years, so that though he could not plant and harvest, the Gentile could, and he could reap the benefits from it. Well, he was skirting around the sabbatical year and the Jubilee, which made the year 132-33 a Jubilee.
Aha!
And that was the last Jubilee in history. And all you have to do is go back every 49 years till you find the first Jubilee. Go back 49 more years till you find year one of the sabbatical cycles that launches the whole thing. And you've got, it's perfect. It's right in the days of Joshua when they conquered the land and divided the land and planted their first crop.
Wow. What if that letter hadn't been written?
But it was.
But it was.
And now we've got everything laid out in 6,000 years of human history. And, of course, there's a lot more than just that.
Oh, yes.
It's fascinating.
And we should really go on. We have about 2 or 3 minutes left here. And in verse 26 in Daniel chapter 9 says, "After 62 weeks shall Messiah be cut off, but not for himself. And the people of the prince that shall come shall destroy the city and the sanctuary." And I'll stop right there. The people of the prince that shall come. Now, yes. What's that talking about?
The prince that shall come is the Antichrist. He's going to commit the abomination of desolation. And the people of his family roots would be the Romans, because they destroyed Jerusalem and the temple in AD 70. So there you have it. Daniel reveals the bloodline of the Antichrist. He's going to be a Roman prince, going to be from the royalty of Rome and the royalty of Greece. And that takes us back, of course, to where the Greeks came from and where the Romans came from.
You know, scholars for years have used the term Greco-Roman, meaning that basically, genealogically, they were somewhat the same people.
Yes.
But then you've taken that a step farther and gone back and documented the origin of the Romans, the origin of the Greeks, and discovered their genealogy. And presto, genealogy, another way to say that is bloodline. Daniel reveals the bloodline of the Antichrist. Yours for $19.95 plus shipping and handling. This will be a great addition to your library. And you're watching this on our website, and it'll tell you how to order. You can also easily call the 800 number that you see. And when you do, just ask them for Daniel Reveals the Bloodline of the Antichrist, and we'll ship it to you right away. Yours for $19.95 plus shipping and handling. And JR, we should mention around this time of the year, it's time to think about maybe giving a gift to somebody else. It's a holiday season. This would make a great gift.
Yes, it would. No commentary on Daniel has ever been written like this one.
That is true. And folks, you might think I'm a little biased here, but believe me when I say no commentary on Daniel like this has ever been written. When JR says it, it's true. It's what's in this that you won't find anywhere else is historical documentation that supports the prophetic interpretation. That's the bottom line.
Yeah.
And we're out of time.
Out of time. So call and get the book, and we'll see you tomorrow. This is J.R. Church and Gary Stearman. Until then, keep looking up.